after you've downed all five bosses in Firelands, you get this nice bridge summoned for you so you can get to the last two. And it's something pretty cool. It's almost like it's molten lava hot and you see it settle and actually form right in front of you. What's on the other side of the bridge? Well, you've got Major Domo, who is a druid who likes to shapeshift. Up front, you'll see a hunter is misdirecting this boss to us because we are all balled up. Because one of his abilities is, when you're balled up seven or more people, he'll transform into this scorpion. You'll see he is building up energy. Every time he hits 100 energy, he can cast the ability Flame Scythe, which deals 75,000 damage divided equally with all the targets in front of him. So we split the damage by all balling up, and hence he's a scorpion because we're all balled up. Now through this portion of the fight, keep an eye on the energy. See how it hits 100, the Flame Scythe happens, our health goes down equally almost, and the healers top us up. It should be easy, but there's one other effect that Flame Scythe does is he gains a stacking adrenaline effect every time he casts it, which increases the amount of energy he gets by 20%. So you're going to notice the energy going up faster, which means he's casting that more frequently, which means our healers got to top us up faster as well. You'll notice as we get higher into the stacks, we're all going to start trading abilities, whether it be Tranquility, whether it be my Divine Guardian to reduce damage to all party members, or my Holy Radiance, which heals all party members within the area. Now, while you guys are watching this effect go faster and faster, and us popping whatever cooldowns we can to stay alive, you'll see we're at 8 stacks now. As the stacks increase, you're wondering, well, how do you stop this effect? Well, the nice thing is when he shapeshifts, it takes away all adrenaline. You'll see here that the priest pops Power Word Barrier. We're doing everything we can to stay alive. We find we can ride it out to about 12, 13 before we need to split. So here you see we do split up and he changes into cat form. He also receives his first stack of Fury, which he gets each time he switches either into cat or scorpion form, which is why we prolonged the first phase as long as we did. Now the boss is going to randomly pounce on one of the members, is why we have him spread out. He'll leave an image of himself behind, which I quickly have to taunt, and wherever he lands, you'll notice he leaves that AoE effect, which, guess what, don't stand in fire. He casts this, Leaping Flames, every 100 energy, and he also has adrenaline, like in the first phase, so it gets faster and faster, so that he'll be, you know, pouncing quicker. We found that we could run this to approximately 6 stacks before we had to switch him up again. To switch him up, we all collapse to push it into Scorpion, but every third transformation, he briefly goes into human form, throws some tornadoes on us for a brief second to incapacitate us for a moment, then he's back into Scorpion. This time, though, it's a little harder because he casts Searing Seeds on all of our members but the tank. Searing Seeds is an ability that gives each player, it's like a living bomb. When it explodes, you have to be away from the party. So they're all running out one at a time because each bomb has its own timer. Each player is responsible to watch their own timer. And they got to get back into the center once it explodes. Because keep in mind, if we don't have 7 people balled up, he's going to transform again. We do push this fight a lot earlier. We push it at 6 stacks. If you remember, we went to 13 last time. But this time it is harder with the Searing Seeds and also with the Furies was stacked to 2, which, you know, gave him 16% more damage on his Flame Scythe. This cat phase Furies up to 3 stacks, which means about 24% harder damage if you stand in fire. We ride this out, though, like we normally would to 6 because there's no additional abilities. Those abilities only really occur the phase after he switches into human form. One thing I really love about this fight is it's going to change over time because as we get more geared, we'll be able to extend the different phases longer, which will make it easier. And if you're a little under-geared for this fight, don't take these switches as the way to do it because it all depends on your gear. You might need to switch a little bit earlier, but keep in mind with that stacking Fury, it means the end might be a little bit harder if you get maybe 6 stacks instead of 5 at the end because now he's hitting even harder. But by switching him quicker, you're not getting that buildup of adrenaline between each phase. So it's been 3 transformations, back to human form. This time he casts Burning Orbs, which you're going to notice orbs all around the outside. It attacks the nearest player, and that effect stacks. It's damage over time. So we swap people in and out. And to be quite honest, we weren't ready for it. It was our first time getting that phase. So we were just kind of, you stand here, and we were popping everything just to down the boss. Our mage received the neck piece, our hunter received the trinket, and the death knight traded in the tier 12 token for some awesome tier 12 shoulders. Plus, we've been spending a little bit money as a guild. We've been buying certain items that we know that will be upgradable to heroic down the road for different characters. We also got these two cleavers, so he's wielding, which are probably worth about 70 grand if you put the two of them together. We also took some of our guild money and bought our mage a staff, since our boomkin is getting the shards to receive the legendary staff. So now that we have that boss down, the next boss that we have our target set on is Ragnaros. Of course, when you down him, you unlock the whole thing so you can choose whether regular mode or heroic mode. Make sure you're subscribed because I have other boss guides that I have coming out and some already posted. The links will be clickable to the left when they're out. And my latest video that I just put out the other day was a simple quick video in Bastion Hold, the new BH boss. Guys, thanks again. Till next time.